In the last tutorial, I showed you how to format text using the native editor that comes with the WordPress site. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to add media to a post, including embedding images, selecting a featured image, and creating image galleries. To begin the process, I'll return to the WordPress dashboard and I'll open up my posts and open up the posts that we've been working on. I want to first embed an image into the post, so I'll put my cursor here because this is where I'd like the image to appear. Next, I'll click on the Add Media button on top of the editor. I'll see a series of images that I've already uploaded to the WordPress site in previous tutorials. To upload a new file, click on the Upload Files tab and then click on the Select Files button. I'll be able to browse my computer for an image. The blue check mark on the image indicates that this is the image I'm going to embed into the post. I can also create attachment details, which I discussed in a previous tutorial, or I can select an alignment option. I'll select left alignment here so the text wraps around the right side of the image. I can also link to a media file, an attachment page, or a custom URL through the image, or have no link at all. The next option is to select the full size or thumbnail of the image. Selecting the thumbnail tells WordPress that you'd like to use the image in a more manageable size with the post. Let's go ahead and click on the Preview Changes button so we can see what this image looks like live on the front end of our site. Remember, the preview area is for you only, and until you update the post, your users can't see that embedded image. If you return to the dashboard and select the image within the post, you can click on the pencil icon to edit the image, or if you'd like to remove the image, click on the X icon. The next option we have is to set a featured image. By scrolling all the way down in the bottom right corner of this page, we can click on the Set Featured Image link. This will take us to that abbreviated view of our Media Manager where we can upload a new file for our featured image. We'll click on the Select Files button here and select an image from our computer. Once the image is uploaded, we can add different attachment details, or we can click on the Set Featured Image button at the bottom of the page to add this as our featured image. We'll see the small thumbnail here indicating which image we're using, and if we scroll to the top of the page, we can click on the Preview Changes button again, and we'll return to the front end to see our featured image. It is important to note that featured images will appear differently depending on the theme that you're using. Another option we have for incorporating media into the post is by inserting an image gallery. I'm going to scroll to the bottom of this post and leave my cursor where I'd like the gallery to appear. Then I'll click on the Add Media button on top of the editor and click on the Create Gallery option within the media library. Just as we did before, I'll click on the Upload Files tab and click on the Select Files button so I can browse my computer for the images I'd like to include in this gallery. I'm going to upload several images at once. As each of these images is loaded into the media library, notice the blue check mark again, which indicates that I'm using these selected images for my gallery. I can deselect any image I'd like to exclude it from the gallery. Please also notice the thumbnails that appear at the bottom of the media library. These are each of the images that will appear in my gallery, and you can imagine that if I have thousands of images within my WordPress site, that the thumbnails come in handy. I've got two images here that are very similar, so I'll deselect one to exclude it from my gallery. I can also add attachment details for each of the images I've uploaded or click on the Create a New Gallery button. I'll be directed to the Edit Gallery page where I have several gallery settings off to the right side. I can have each image linked to an attachment page, a media file, or have no link at all, and I can also determine how many columns I'd like to appear within the gallery. I also have the ability to have the images appear in a random order, which means that each time the post is refreshed, the gallery will look a little bit different. Before we insert this gallery into our post, notice that we have the option here to create a caption for each of the images. I'll show you how these captions look once we update the post with the gallery, but you can hover your mouse over each of the images to see the caption, and this is especially useful if you're going to link these files to attachment pages in your site. Once we've added a caption for each of these images, we'll click on the Insert Gallery button at the bottom of the media library. Once we do, we'll be directed back to our post and we can see the gallery that we've just added. If we hover our mouse over the images, we can also see the caption that we've added for each image. Please remember that none of this media will be visible for our front-end users until we update the post. Once we click on the Update button, we'll return to the front end of our WordPress site and we'll refresh the page to see all the media that we've added. The first thing we'll notice is the featured image we selected for this post, and we'll notice the embedded image within the text of the post and the gallery that we've added at the bottom of the text. We can hover our mouse over each image to see our captions. The next tutorial in this series will show you how to create pages within your WordPress site.